Welcome to another Blender tutorial, and in this one we're going to be looking at how to export a image sequence or video with a transparent background. In this one we're using Blender 2.77, but this works for as far back as 2.66 as far as I know. Now we have here set up a normal situation in our node editor to export a video, and we have a movie clip node feeding into a mixer node, going to our composite for our output, and a viewer node to be able to see it in our viewport. Now to get transparency we have two options. We can use a keying node or some keying situation and feed that in, and that will key on the green that I've selected here and will give us transparency, turning that green background into transparent and showing through whatever is in this lower layer, whether it be an image, a video, or a color. We also have the ability to feed in a mask, and in this case I'm going to invert it with an inverter node and feed it into the factor button, and that will add that information to the alpha channel information and give us transparency in the background here and where the mask was. Now, at the moment what is showing through is white. Now we want to show through transparency. Now if in the mixer node, if we were to say, let's just zero our color down to black, you'll find it will just turn it into black because it's not actually zeroing the color, it's just turning it to black. And then if you say, well, okay, let's get the alpha channel and turn it down to zero to make it nice and transparent. If you do that, it does make the entire picture's transparency into full transparency, and it will mix it, because it's a mixer, with the movie clip, and the sum total of zero background with the movie clip gives us zero picture. So that is not going to work for us. So we can't use the mixer node, but we can use something which is designed to work dedicated to this. We can go add color alpha over, that's the alpha over mix. Mixer, and as the name suggests, it's going to work with the alpha channel. You can put the pre-multiplied on. Now if we were to take the keying node with our green background keyed and plug that into our composite out and our viewer, yes, we have transparency. The green has turned transparent, and like the mixer, it's going to show whatever is in that bottom layer, whether it be an image, a movie, or a solid color. And we can also take our mask, which I've now inverted, and plug that into the factor, the same as with the mixer. It will add that information to the alpha channel. Also, we have transparency here and here. Now, if we were to zero our color down to black, the same happens as with the mixer. It turns black because it's color black. But if we put that back up and say, right, we're going to take the alpha channel and zero it, unlike the mixer, it will take only the alpha channel and zero it and not mix the picture together like the mixer did to get a zero picture. It will only give us zero background, so that works fine. But you will see that the borders here of this mask have a white color, the same color that is there. It means that this alpha channel in the halfway that is not fully transparent is going to show some white as well. So what we need to do there is take our color white and put it to black. And black in alpha channel language means full transparency. So it is going to zero the alpha channel and zero the mid grays. Anything that's not full white or full black, it will zero it also to full transparency. So there we have a transparent background. Now in the export here, we can export it as a PNG, a TIFF, or a target image sequence. And some of the video codecs will allow you to export a video with some transparent backgrounds, but I'm going to generally use a PNG sequence to export that as an image sequence with a transparent background.